Hi, I am Asghar Ghori. Today I'm going to talk about how to create local user accounts in Linux using different criteria. I will also share with you the files that are updated when user accounts are added to the system and the files that are referenced for default values. For demonstration, I will use my CentOS system called Server 1. However, the concepts and procedures I am going to share apply to other popular Linux distributions and their spin-offs as well, with the exception of some minor differences in command names or command options. For more details and for help with RHCSA, RHCE, CompTIA Linux Plus, and LPIC 1 certification exams, see my latest publications as shown on this slide. A lot of the information presented in these books is also applicable to Linux Foundation certification exams as well. You can obtain your copies of the books from major online retail and app stores. The topics I will cover in the next few minutes are listed here on this slide. Number 1, user account basics. Number 2, files updated by account creation process. Number 3, files that supply default values. Number 4, a quick look at the usered command. Number 5, create a user account with default values. And number 6, create a user account with custom values. Just like in any other operating system, we create user accounts on Linux to allow authorized users to log in to the system and perform the tasks that they are allowed to. Each user is assigned a login name that is unique on the system. Linux supports three fundamental user account types, and they can be categorized into three groups. One group that contains only one user account, the administrative user account called root, which is the super user with full access to all services and administrative functions on the system. This account is created by default during Linux installation. It is not advisable to log in directly as the root user. The second group includes normal users with limited privileges. These users cannot perform any administrative function, but they can run any application or program that they have authorization for. These users can have any login name assigned to them, as long as the username is unique on that system. Users are encouraged to log in with their assigned user credentials. The third and the last group contains special user accounts called service accounts. Service accounts in Linux are responsible for taking care of their respective services installed on the system. For instance, a Linux system with Apache web service installed will have a service account called Apache. Accounts for services such as network time protocol, file transfer protocol, and email will also be there if their respective software are installed. The service user accounts are not intended for logging in. They are there simply to take care of their associated services. There are four text files that are located in the etc directory that is stored user account information. These files are updated when a user account is created, modified, or deleted. These files are password, shadow, group, and gshadow. The password and shadow files store a one-line entry for each user account that exists on the system, and the group and gshadow files contain a one-line entry for each group account that is on the system. I will provide an analysis of these files in a separate video. There are two text configuration files in Linux that define default settings for new user accounts. One of them is called login.defs, and it is located in the etc directory. And the other one is the usered file, which is located in the etc default directory. The settings in these files are applied to user accounts at the time of their creation, unless you want to override them with custom values. Common settings stored in these files include the minimum and maximum numeric identifiers for normal and service user accounts, the default shell to assign, the directory paths to copy the default user initialization files from, the paths to store user home directories, and so on. The usered command is responsible for user account creation in Linux. This command has a number of options available to override its default behavior. Some of the common options are -u to specify a numeric user identifier, -o to use a non-unique numeric user identifier, -c to enter general comments, -m to create home directory if it does not already exist, -d to stipulate the absolute path to the location of the home directory, and -s to specify the path and name for the shell file. There are additional options available with the command. Check out the manual pages for details. In order to create a user account, use all the defaults that are defined in the login.devs and user.add files, we simply run the user.add command and enter a unique login name for the user. For instance, let's run user.add user5000 to create a user account called user5000 and see what it does. User.add user5000. The command was executed successfully and the user account was created. Let's check the entries in the password shadow group and gshadow files. Grep user5000 /etc/password. The user5000 is the user account name. 1003 is the numeric identifier assigned to this user account. 1003 is the group identifier assigned to this user account. /home/user5000 is the home directory for this user to store personal files. And /bin/bash is the bash shell file. Grep for user5000 /etc/shadow file. User5000 is the username, and then there are additional fields that are specific to something called password aging, password and password aging. Grep for user5000 in the etc group file, and there's an entry there for it, user5000 with group identifier 1003 and entry in the gshadow file, user5000. Most of this information was obtained from the login.devs and user.add files. Let's assign this user a password with the password command. passwd user5000. New password, let's assign user5000 and user5000. And now let's switch into this account for some basic verification checks. So we're going to use the su command. su-user5000. Let's run the pwd command to check the home directory location and run the id command to find this username, numeric user identifier, numeric group identifier, and name of the group. I'm going to log off now as user5000 and return to the root user by pressing the Control and D key combination. So that's how we create a user account with all the default values obtained from the config file. So that's how we create a user account with all the default values obtained from the config files. Now I'm going to create another user account called user10000 and supply a few non-default values to it. I will use the C shell as opposed to the default bash shell. The C shell is located in the /bin directory. I will specify a home directory for this user called user10000 under the /var directory. I will supply the comment, this user is located in Toronto, Canada, and I will use a user identifier 10,000. Let me type the command. User add minus s to specify the name and location of the C shell file, minus m to create the home directory if it does not already exist, minus d to specify the name and location of the user home directory, minus c for comments, this user is located in Toronto, Canada. Minus u to specify a numeric identifier, 10,000, and then the name of the user account that we want to create. Press the Enter key, and there you go. The user was created. Let's assign this user a password with the password command. Password user10000 and there you go. Password is assigned. Let's take a quick look at the entries in the password shadow group and G shadow files. Grep user 10,000 password file, and there is an entry for this user. That's the name of the user. 10,000 is the numeric identifier. 10,000 is the group identifier. This user is located in Toronto, Canada. Are the comments /var/user10,000 is the home directory name and location, and this is the C shell file. In the shadow file, this is the entry name of the user, and this is the encrypted password that we've just assigned to this user, and the rest are password aging entries. I'm going to explain that in some other video. In the group file, user 10,000, and 10,000 is the group identifier, and in the G shadow file is an entry for the group. Now we can switch into this account with the switch user command su-user10,000, and there we go. And now we can run the id command, we can use the pwd command, and I think that's all for basic verification. I'm going to log off now as user 10,000 and return to the root user by pressing the Control and D key combination. There you go. And this brings us to the end. Try the examples presented in the video on your own system. So we covered user account basics, files updated by account creation process, files that supply default values to new accounts, and we looked at the user add command. A quick look at the user add command, and we demonstrated how to create a user account with default and custom values. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up, comment down below, subscribe to channel NixEducation to get notifications of new videos, share this video with your friends and colleagues. Thank you for watching. Bye now.